peace, Brother C. I got your video. And I've done a video about black nationalism too, because I was charged up about it. You know, where, you know, they were saying to me that if I didn't support going back to Africa, that I wasn't an African, or that I wasn't a nationalist. And I am. And I think that, first of all, black nationalism is more, it's an ideology, and I keep explaining this to people. It's an ideology that we're trying to make a reality. And it starts first in your mind, is where you identify yourself as an African person. You know, in other words, a descendant of Africans, that make you an African person. And then you look to work with other African people to build the quote-unquote African nation. Now, we specifically here in America focused on a nation within a nation. And I think that it was some white people, I think, that coined that term, if I'm not mistaken. A nation within a nation, because of the disparities and things like that. I'm not sure. I could be wrong on that. Either I read that in a reference somewhere or something. But anyway, that aside, anytime, I'm going to just say this to you. Anytime you hear somebody talking about going back to your ancient ways, them very ancient ways that landed your ass on a boat, you got to be careful about those kind of people. Okay? Because that shows you their ignorance. All right? Because we're evolving. African people are evolving all over the world. And even though they still practice some ancient practices, you know, that really don't make sense, such as female mutilation in the name of some cultural aspect, which I find absolutely ridiculous. But that women are still subjecting themselves to that shit. But they waking up over there in Africa too about having their vaginas all cut up. And cut off for what? You know, and the initial rationale was for the pleasure of a man. You know what I'm saying? So the women over there are waking up. So the fact of the matter is that we're evolving, okay? And anytime you find somebody always talking about going back to their ancient ways, that's just some rhetoric that's in their heads that has been spoken at every lecture, every turn. For African people, because they can't think of no other futuristic way for African people. They can only think of us in terms of our ancient ways. And like I said, it's them very ancient ways that got your ass over here in America. Okay, for some of us. All right? So I think that, you know, I ignore those people. You know what I'm saying? Because I know they're ignorant. They really don't know. And as my brother said on our list, is that even Marcus Garvey didn't advocate a mass movement to Africa. Because I'm going to tell you something. When they did that African colonization thing back in the 1800s, I think it was, or 1700s, or whatever it was, where they went over to, I'm trying to think of the name of the damn country. I can't think of the name of the country. But anyway, them African black folk from America went over there, them free blacks, went over there and went to treating those native people just like Europeans did. Okay? Thought of them in the same vein, treated them in the same way. Okay? And I'm putting out my earring because, you know, I'm always advertising. Okay? But anyway, you like them? I could make you some. Just let me know. But anyway, first of all, black people here in America got to know, for the past 500 years, we've been indoctrinated with a certain mindset. You understand? A certain cultural way of looking at things. And so in order to be totally free, I think, is that you have to first cleanse your mind of all of your biases. Because I noticed in your video that the first thing you said about it was a jungle. Do you know how modern Africa is? How many modern countries and cities that in those countries that there are? I mean, everybody's not going, everybody's not in the bush in Africa, okay? Even though a bush does exist, because they have poverty in Africa. But they also have wealth in Africa, too. And you have black folks in Africa that are taking advantage of that wealth and not distributing it to the poor, just like they have over here in America. So, you know, we have to really take a look at our own mindset as far as how do we work with African people here? I mean, we can't even get past our ideologies about Africa itself and what it is. So, you know, I personally, I don't waste my time with them back to Africa, back to our ancient ways people, because I know that they're ignorant. They really don't know that it's them very ancient ass ways that got us into the situations that we're in. You know, we have to evolve and go to another level is what I'm saying. So, I just think that, you know, what a black nationalist thinks about, and this is just my own assessment, is that how do we link up with the people in Africa? How do we identify with the people in Africa? And then, like you said, there are how many 50-something countries over in Africa? So which country do we want to link up in? Which country do we want to do business in, or do we want to establish some kind of business in? And then we have to go with the government, how the government is set up for business, or immigrants for that matter. You know, you talk about visas, you talk about all those things like that. Because when you're repatriating to another country, I don't know whether people are willing to give up their American citizenship. I would advise don't give up your citizenship, it's yours. So you have a right to your citizenship here after all your ancestors have done. You know, you got a right to that citizenship. So what countries accept dual citizenship is the question, okay? You have to look at that as well, because some will require you to give up your citizenship here in the U.S. because they don't have dual citizenship. I know, I think that they were looking at dual citizenship in Ghana at one time. And I think it's a couple of others, but you got to do your research on the country that you're focused on. So, you know, my thing is, for real, and that's what this video is about. When I heard you say somebody was talking about going back to the ancient ways, I'm like, beware of those people, okay? Because they're more rhetorical than anything else. They might have been to Africa one damn time, and you know how you treat a guest, right? A guest really don't get to see what it really is like, okay? You have to be there for a while to know what a country is really, really like. The politics, the people, the different factions and things like that. You have to be there for a while, sometimes a year or two or three or four, before you get the gist and understanding of how the people really are. You understand? And whether there are anti-American black people over there, because you know what? There are anti-American black folk over in Africa. I'm just going to put that on record. Because the information that they receive from America about blacks in America, they're disgusted. And I would be too if I saw some of the shit that comes out of America about black folk. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, that's my thought. Anytime you hear somebody talk about that, go back to the ancient ways shit. Look out, okay? Because now you're talking about someone's religion, which is a personal thing. You understand their politics and things like that. You know, so if I was to go to Africa, I would know everything about the country I'm going to, except for the mentality of the people, until I get there and I stay there for a while. Okay, so for those who want to repatriate, like I said, those that want to repatriate, they gone. They done repatriated, and those that are going to repatriate ain't on the internet talking about it. They're actually making preparations to go. But all them talking that shit, that's all they doing, bro. They just talking, okay? So I hope you didn't get your blood pressure up listening to those black people, because you know they're romanticizing a very serious situation. And I kind of, fault the lecturers and things like that, because they just give people little bites and stuff. They don't And it's hard to do in a lecture too, to really talk about the nuances of Africa and the intricacies of Africa. It's really hard to get all of that out in a lecture. And so what people pull away from that is the rhetoric. You know, back to Africa. Yes, all Africans need to be over in Africa. And even Marcus Garvey, like I said, didn't advocate that. You know, he understood that we're here in America, we're over in England, we're over in Jamaica, we're over in Bahamas, that Africans are everywhere, and that Africans connect just based, you know, our ideologies as African people. But we're still individuals with different feelings and things like that, and different influences. And those are the things that the individual has to address within themselves, because it's kind of like you have to open up your mind. You understand, you can't be so closed-minded, you know. And like you said, people do have to self-educate themselves about the continent of Africa, but what you get in a book is not what you're going to get when you get on the ground, because you got to remember those books were written by human beings, okay, with their own variations and thoughts on Africa and their own perceptions and things like that. So you got to take all that with a grain of salt as well. So when you're approaching going to a foreign country, you got to use some kind of common sense and intellect combined, okay? Because, you know, just getting on a plane and thinking you gonna go over there and people gonna embrace you, yeah, they will at first, but when they find out that your ass is poor as Job and you can't bring shit to the table, then you gonna see a whole lot of changes. Because I'm gonna tell you something, they have their own poor. They don't need no poor ass folk from America coming over there to Africa talking about we here to be repatriate. They got their immigration laws and everything else. You understand? So I think people really, you know, those who are serious, they're serious. Those who aren't, they're just caught up in the rhetoric. Know that, believe that, and trust me on that. With that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Seeker. Peace, brother. Have a great day.